What's the obvious difference, or one obvious difference anyway, between the music of Brahms and Chopin? Nothing comes to mind?
I feel like it's, I think it's the overall, like, scale of things in terms of, like, the arrangement, voicing, it's a lot wider, broader. I feel like it's less...
Are you talking about Brahms?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I feel like Chopin and Brahms are very melodic, but in very different ways.
Uh-huh.
Very.
So, you know that, what, have you played any other Brahms?
Opus 76, parts of that set.
Yeah, so, you know, so this is an early piece, right?
Yeah,
one of the interesting things about Brahms is you can't tell the difference between an early piece and a late piece.
I mean, I personally disagree.
Okay, what does it sound like an early Brahms piece?
I'd say
why?
Because he takes a lot from other people in this piece.
And he does it in other pieces?
I feel like he, in, as he grew into the later piano music,
like what,
he,
for instance?
Like,
well, like, say, if you look at the Opus 10 ones, they're also early.
Yeah.
I mean, it sounds pretty cool.
That's
to
true.
Me. See,
yeah.
I got you there.
You got
me. But I can get you, we don't have time to go in, and I can get you a lot. Like, the waltzes, for instance, Opus 39.
Okay.
They're young and old at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I have a reason. I have my own special reason of why I think this happened to him, or why this is for him. This is, I mean, it's because I was really influenced by what he said about himself when he composed. So when he could only compose when he went to this special place, like maybe a Seventh Sense or a special zone.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, I think it was a, well, he said it was a spiritual place. He didn't exactly say that it was with God, but it was like something like a higher power.
Mm-hmm.
So when he was in that place, he was not in an age range of 10 years old or 80 years old. You know, he was just
mm-hmm.
in that super place. Anyway, what I was trying to get you to say is one of the big differences, I think, for most people and historians is that, you know, Brahms really writes in an orchestral way. And Chopin, well, he was a piano nerd. So that's a huge, huge thing.
Yeah.
So I take issue with your performance when it departs from being for orchestra and it becomes like for Superman who came in here on his with his superpowers and was zooming around the room so fast that you can't hear the notes.
Okay.
I'm not quite sure why you do that at the end, aside from the thrill. But I think like it, this piece could have easily been scored for orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So I think you need to honor that more. I've never seen this edition before because this is not really Dover.
It's not really, it's that they took it directly from the piano, I think the original first.
But there are a lot of misreadings in here. You have a lot of misreadings. And then there's a lot of things that you do that I think you think are right that are actually not. You know, like learn wrong notes, but you play them with great conviction. So I'm not sure what if I should take those away from you or if you want to just look at the score. You know, so can we just start from the beginning? I want to make a few comments here with you, mostly about setting it in the more orchestral context. And when is this piano? You know, okay, so Brahms played the modern piano. One of the things he said about pianists is that they pedal, they don't know how to pedal, they mush everything together, and they really, you know, it's like mushy, mushy soup. The patterns and things are not clear. So you don't pedal, especially when you get going fast. You need to, it has to be clear. You have to be able to understand.
This doesn't make any sense.
That's a little bit how you sound. The other thing is, so Brahms' piano, I have a piano that was built when Brahms was around, and he couldn't have even played it. I don't know. I asked my piano, but I didn't get an answer. So you really need to understand that when he writes piano, he's not talking about a he's talking about this instrument, and you, if, I think you need to respect that. Not play for you where it says piano.
Can you play the opening figure one?
Thank you.
not flutter. Change, change, change. You can change. You have to be able to hear everything you do in order to move forward.